Hiya, I am Husky Light. Thank you for dropping by. I am sticking my ugly mug on. I'm trying to push myself and do a bit of transformation work here, and I still get nervous on YouTube after all this time. So I'm just stepping out of my comfort zone at the moment, and doing the cards like this for this week. So, Aquarius, this is for you. As I say, thank you for your likes, your shares, your subscribes, Google Pluses, everything. I really appreciate it. And I'm so happy that you're here to support me and that I'm helping you. So this is your cards. We are going from, where are we going from? We are going from Monday the 17th of August through to Sunday the 23rd of August. So here we go. Hope you enjoy. Right, we are starting off with the Wheel of Fortune in your health position. Make sure that's in the right Wheel of Fortune in your health position. It depends on how you have been for the last few weeks. So in the past couple of weeks, if you've been feeling absolutely brilliant, unfortunately the Wheel of Fortune is going to change in your health this week, and maybe you'll get a cough and a cold, maybe you'll get an allergy, maybe you'll just be find the need to rest more than you have been doing. You won't feel as great. You might just need to get some more sleep, eat right, make sure you're drinking enough water, things like that. Also in the health department, if you are going through some stress because of changes at the moment in your life, whatever those changes may be, it may be that the stress is getting a bit much for you, and that's not making you feel so good either. Try and be as positive as you can. If you're going through changes, just go with the flow. Try not to stress out about them, and that way you may not feel so run down during the week. For those of you who have had health problems, who have been feeling a bit off or tired or whatever the problem's been lately, it's turning the opposite way for you. So this week you're going to be feeling better, you're going to have more energy, and you're generally going to feel a lot better about yourself. You're going to have a bit more get up and go with it. So depending on which way the Wheel of Fortune is going to go for you is depending on what you've been like lately. Six of Swords is your next card. Six of Swords is in your career and your finance. So in your work position, if you are in if you've been in a job for a while, or you've got a long-term career or anything like that, just make sure, for some of you, you might actually feel like you're wanting to leave, that it no longer works for you, that it's no longer serving you in the way it once did, and you're getting itchy feet, and you've got this thought in your head that I just want to move. Trust that the universe is taking you where you want to be, is guiding you to where you want to be, to a better job, to a better career, to a better lifestyle, to something that is going to suit you a lot better, if that's how you're feeling this week. Also, it's a really good week for you to start a new business. If you want to start a new business, get as much help as you can, seek out as much information as you can about it, and start not necessarily taking actions, but start thinking about the plan, start planning, start putting things, start the thoughts going through your head if you want to start a new business. And that you might be at the point where you're actually ready to start it this week, but if not, you can start to think about it and start to plant those seeds. We are still around the new moon, so things can come to fruition if you're thinking about them and thinking of making that change. For some of you also, I feel you could actually, you won't be moving jobs or anything, you could actually be moving residence in jobs. So the building where you work, you could be moving to another building, or you could be moving a department away somewhere. So you're actually physically moving within your job, and it will work out well for you. You may find it's actually closer to work, to home for you, so you have less of a journey to make every day to go to work. It will work out in the best way for you, so you'll be quite happy about that. Finance-wise is the financial tide is turning for you, just like the wheel of fortune turned for you before. So again, it depends on where you've been for the past week, couple of weeks, how things have been for you as to how the tide is turning. If you've been struggling lately, then there is going to be more money coming in this week, or things are going to seem better. Things are not going to be as much of a struggle as they may have been in the recent past. You may get a small windfall, you may get a promotion, you may get something that increases your money a little bit. Somebody could lend you some money, you could get some money as a gift from a friend or a family member. It could work like that. And the opposite way, again, if you've been riding high for a while, if it's been sort of pouring in, you've been doing really well with money, things could slow down a little, but I don't think they're going to get really bad or anything like that. Things may slow down a little bit. You may have some unexpected bills that come through that you need to pay out for, which may leave you with not as much money as you had before. Your car might break down, or vet's bills, or just something unexpected that you might have to dip into your savings for it. So just be aware of that. However it's been the last few weeks, the tide is turning for you this week. So it's going to be less or more depending on what your situation is, Aquarius. Right, judgment. Turn it the right way. Judgment is in your friends and your family position. So don't jump to conclusions. Don't make hasty decisions. Don't judge friends or other people in your family. You need to, if this is you've got to give more thought to things, think things through before you make assumptions or jump to conclusions. In any sort of friend or family situation this week, it could be the opposite way around. Somebody could actually be doing this to you. They may not know the whole story about something, and they're just maybe going off your past behavior or their past thoughts about you, and just jumping to conclusions, making up their own stories, and going, yeah, this is what's happening, and it's not true at all. If this is the case, you need to put them straight and make things clear about it. And don't let them judge you. Don't do that, and don't do it back to somebody else within your friends and family. They will have a very legitimate reason as to why they're doing something or what their reasoning is. And you're not to jump in and make hasty decisions about it. You could be sort of left with egg on your face. You could have to take the statement back again, at another point if you jump to conclusions and make hasty decisions about somebody. So again, it's working both ways. It could be you, it could be somebody else within the family. Just be aware of what's going on. If they're making those sort of decisions about you, if they're jumping to conclusions, just realize that it's their problem. It's not for you to try and sort of be clear about what you're saying if you need to say something to them, but it's their problem. It's something they need to work on. It's something they need to work out on their own if they're the sort of person that's just always jumping on the bandwagon going, aha, I know what you're doing. I know what's going on. Well, no, you probably don't, because you haven't said anything, so don't do it. It's their problem. Let them sort it out. Right, your next card is in your spiritual. It's the moon in reverse. Okay, the moon in reverse. You are very, very psychic at the moment. You are very intuitive at the moment. Go with your gut instinct. Go with your intuition. The only thing is, because it's in reverse, it may not be as clear as it usually is for you, because it's in reverse. But you are actually you're very psychically open at the moment, very spiritually open. So don't ignore your intuition, because it's coming through very strong. It might just take a little bit longer for you to work it out or to get the messages. It might be a little bit slower coming through before you realize what they are. But you are very, very open. Please don't be overly anxious spiritually this week. it may be because some of the messages coming through are not quite as clear as usual. It might make you a little bit anxiety ridden. It might make you a little bit snappy. It might make you a little bit more irritable and stressed. Now, remember what I said about health at the beginning with your health card? Don't let that happen. Try and stay positive about everything. It's like you've got all this information flooding through, but because it's in reverse, it's just going to take you a little bit longer to work it out. And you will do, and it'll happen. You'll have a lot of insights coming through to you, but you won't be quite as sure what they mean as usual, even though you're so open. It's going to be harder for you to interpret things this week, so just be aware of that. And our last card is the High Priestess, and this is in your love. Sorry about the sun going in and out. It's a bit daft at the moment. Right, there's your High Priestess. So if this is you, you are going to be a lot more attractive to others this week. Yay. People are going to be throwing themselves at your feet all week. You are going to be a lot more attractive. You're going to be feeling a lot sexier. You're going to be feeling a lot more beautiful. This doesn't matter if you're male or female. If you're taking on these traits, you're going to be a lot more intuitive. Again, I've already said that with the moon card. You're going to be a bit unapproachable, a bit mysterious, and you're going to be very attractive to people around you. You're going to get a lot of people coming up to you. They're attracted to you. They're going to be drawn to you like a magnet. If this is not you, so if you're in a long-term relationship and this is you, you could be in some extra kisses and hugs this week, because you're going to be particularly attractive to your other half. And if you're looking for a relationship, one could very, very well be drawn to you this week. If this is a person either coming into your life, if you are single, again, you're going to find them very, very attractive. They are going to be sexy, mysterious, and you're going to be fascinated by them. Just take it slowly, okay? But she's very much tied to the moon. And say again, this can be male or female, but you're going to be very, very attracted to them. Go with your instincts on it. That's why I say take it slowly. If you've just met them, go with your instincts. Although they are mysterious and sort of seem unapproachable, though, once you get underneath, they're all gooey and soft underneath. They're really, really nice. So go with it. If this is your other half, if you're in a long-term relationship, then you are going to be extra attracted to them this week, and things are going to run smoother and things are going to look better for you, and they're just going to have that extra kissable appeal this week that you're going to be drawn to. So on the love front this week, it's whether it's you or whether it's somebody coming into your life or whether it's your other half, it's a really nice energy to have around you this week. If this is you, use the power wisely, because you are going to be feeling a lot more attractive, and even if you don't notice it yourself, you're just going to notice that people are more drawn to you. So have fun with that one. Let me know how that one goes, whether it's you or somebody else, or you meet somebody like that. That's brilliant. So if you'd like a personal reading, click on that link up there in the corner. My Patreon, if you want to donate or gift or anything, my Patreon details or my PayPal, whichever you prefer, are down below. Thank you again for subscribing. I love you all loads. You're going to have an interesting week, I think. Have a brilliant week. And I will see you in the morning for the angel cards. And have a great time. All right, take care. Bye.